Marinduque Representative Lord Alan Velasco hit Speaker Alan Peter Cayetano once more, saying he bastardized the House of Representatives. This comes after Cayetano's House speech on Tuesday, October 6, where he fast-tracked a passage on second reading the proposed 4.5 trillion peso budget in 2021, then suspended the session until November 16. In a statement, Velasco says, quote, "Because of Speaker Cayetano's desperate attempt to stay in power, he has bastardized the institution we swore to protect and respect and committed serious violations of the Constitution to save himself." Velasco adds, "Cayetano's latest play violated Section 16, Article 6 of the Constitution, which requires both houses of Congress to get each other's consent when adjourning session for more than 3 days." Velasco also slams Cayetano's decision to strip pro-Velasco lawmakers of their key House posts, allegedly because they were using their positions to undermine Cayetano. Velasco allies who lost their committee chairmanships are Helen Tan of the Health Committee, Economic Affairs Committee Chair Sharon Garin, and Youth and Sports Development Committee Chair Eric Martinez. Earlier on October 2, Deputy Speaker Mikey Romero also lost his post. Cayetano and Velasco are currently embroiled in a bitter feud over their term-sharing deal as House Speaker. Under the agreement, Cayetano is to serve as Speaker in the first 15 months of the 18th Congress, then Velasco takes over in the 21 months after that. Education Secretary Leonor Briones draws flak from several youth groups for claiming victory over COVID-19 during her speech in the opening of classes on Monday, October 5.
"We will not allow COVID-19 to destroy our children's education and their future."
The College Editors Guild of the Philippines and the National Union of Students of the Philippines point out the school opening could hardly be considered a victory, as it has only worsened the struggles of Filipino students in the pandemic. CEGP Deputy Secretary General Regina Tolentino says millions of students had dropped out of school because they can't cope with the new mode of education. The NUSP says Briones' remark and the Education Department's budget for 2021 only show that the government is not prioritizing the needs of students and teachers. Anakbayan Cebu spokesperson Sayan Adrian Rom calls Briones' remarks, quote, "distasteful," because the secretary insisted to open classes despite the issues faced by students and teachers. Kabataan Party List Laguna also emphasizes the struggles of students, such as the lack of gadgets and access to internet, as well as learning modules. At least 2.3 million students dropped out of enrolling for the new school year because of the demands of distance learning. Gabriela Women's Party List stresses the opening of classes pushed family incomes to drop because of pandemic restrictions and lack of government subsidy to students. Briones clarifies on Monday that her remark was meant for groups pushing for an academic freeze.
"Isang victory yan para sa education, dahil itong mga kalaban natin ay nag-i-insist na education freeze. Gusto nila sara lahat dahil hindi kaya ng DepEd, hindi kaya ng pamahalaan."
Meantime, the Health Department reports 2,825 new cases of COVID-19 on Wednesday, October 7, bringing the total cases to 329,637. The Health Department also logs 60 new deaths, bringing the total number of COVID-19 deaths to almost 6,000. United States President Donald Trump is scrambling to get his re-election campaign back on track after 3 nights of hospital treatment for COVID-19. Just less than 4 weeks away from the November free election day, Trump's Democrat rival Joe Biden emerges as the likely winner based on latest surveys. A CNN poll reveals Biden has a 57-41% national advantage among likely voters, with women voters going 66-32% in his favor. Biden's advance comes as Trump was forced off the campaign trail after testing positive for COVID-19. While being treated at the Walter Reed Medical Center, Trump broke protocol after briefly going out to wave to supporters outside the hospital. Experts say Trump was highly infectious during that time, and his bodyguards who accompanied him inside his vehicle were put at risk. Meanwhile, former First Lady Michelle Obama on Tuesday, October 6, calls Trump racist for his strategy of fear-mongering and promoting division and ugly conspiracy theories that could destroy America. She says Trump and his Republican allies are unfairly stoking fears about African Americans. Rock legend and guitarist Eddie Van Halen dies on Tuesday, October 6. He was 65. In a tweet, Van Halen's son Wolfgang says his father fought a long battle with cancer. Wolfgang, who plays bass for iconic rock band Van Halen with his father, tweets, "Every moment I've shared with him on and off stage was a gift. Van Halen is known to have health problems that interfered with his work for years. He underwent hip surgery in 1999 and had part of his tongue removed in 2000 after being diagnosed with cancer. Van Halen founded the rock group with his brother Alex in the early 70s and quickly skyrocketed to worldwide superstardom. Van Halen is best known for the anthemic 1984 hit Jump." A video claiming former Senator Bongbong Marcos is the new Vice President of the Philippines is false. This video, uploaded by YouTube channel Showbiz Fanatics on Wednesday, September 30, also claims incumbent Vice President Lenny Robredo will be dismissed from office. Some Facebook pages also reposted the same video. Robredo is still the official Vice President of the Philippines as of October 7, 2020. The Manila Times article referred to as the source in the video did not say Robredo will soon be unseated. The Manila Times article was only about the news that Supreme Court Justice Marvick Leonen is finally acting on the electoral protest filed by Marcos in 2016. The Supreme Court on September 29 voted unanimously to move forward in the vice presidential electoral protest. This is not the first time that rapper debunked a video posted by Showbiz Fanatics. In September, Showbiz Fanatics uploaded a false video that claimed the Commission on Audit is running after Robredo. It also falsely claimed the Supreme Court affirmed that ABS-CBN is guilty of multiple charges.